Hello friends, my name is Jenna, and the AC is on right now because it's over 100 degrees today. Hi friends, my name is Jenna, and I have the AC on right now, so I don't know if you can hear me or not. But today, I hope you don't mind my pillows and this blue backdrop. I know in most of my videos I'm like this close to the camera, but because I have very little space to film. Anyway, the premise of this video today is to test out Shop Miss A items, or Miss A. Not like the K-pop group, but like the website. I have all my Shop Miss A items in a Sephora bag. I wanted to compare Shop Miss A items to my normal products, so let's begin. I'm gonna do one side more high-end and the other side using Miss A products. I'm gonna be doing my brows, which is unusual for me. I've recently been trying out brows and they look cute. They look cute. But for today, I'm just gonna mix the two products I'm using. So I'm gonna mix the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz in Ebony and the AOA Wonder Brow in Ebony on my eyebrows, because that's what I've been doing recently. In order to do the pomade, I'm gonna use the Miss A set. This was $10.55. The pomade was $1. Can you believe $10.55 for a carrier and brushes? These brushes have a weird scent to them. Or is it? I think it's the cap? The holder? Because they've been smelling really chemically. And I've washed these. I'm gonna use the AOA Studio E133 USA brush. It's just a brow brush. For the high-end side, I'm gonna be using the Anastasia Beverly Hills number 12 brush. This side will be Miss A, and this side will be the normal tools I use. So here we go. I'm gonna start off with the brow wiz and see how that goes. Also, before I start my brows, I tweezed them with the Precision Slant Tweezers from AOA Studio. I believe this is $1. If not, I'm gonna put the price on the screen right here. And it works pretty well. I mean, it's a tweezer, it plucks. So I kind of just lightly go in the center. Now I'm gonna go in with the pomade. I've been using this quite a bit and I like it. For a dollar, it's not bad at all. So I'm just gonna take some on my brush and go off of the back of my hand to get a more precise tip and go in. I love a fluffy brow. So that's what I'm gonna try to attempt today. When you do your brows, you always gotta go in with the big mirror to see if they're even. I think that's as good as I'm gonna get it for today. What I will say is that the AOA brush isn't bad, but I would still prefer my Anastasia one because it has a thinner point. I can really get that precise line. Typically, this is the easier eyebrow to do, and this isn't thin enough for me to perfectly get that tail shape. But again, it's like $1 or under $1, so it's not a bad eyebrow brush at all. And the Anastasia one is roughly $18. No, just get yourself an AOA one. Now I'm gonna carve out my brows using the P. Louise base. So I'm gonna take the AOA Studio E122 USA brush, and I'm gonna take the Morphe M421. I'm really getting it saturated in my brush, and I'm gonna go in. The first thing I noticed is that the AOA Studio brush is really soft. Now I'm gonna go in with the Alamar Cosmetics palette, and I'm gonna take Coco Taxi and put that on my crease. So I'm gonna go in with the E128 brush. So far, this brush isn't bad. Oh, actually, it's quite nice. It's not stiff or anything. Now for my normal eye, I'm gonna take the Makeup Geek pointed crease brush. Now I'm just gonna blend that all out with the AOA Studio E129 brush. These AOA Studio brushes are really soft. And I'm surprised. Like, only $1. And I'm gonna take the Morphe M433. Both of these are very tapered brushes that come in from two sides. For the next color, I'm gonna be taking the AOA Studio E130 brush and the Makeup Shack T64, either work in this orange or this red. I'm not sure yet. I think I might do the brick red. Oh wow, that's pigmented. Working in tiny circles, always keeping in mind the type of shape you want to do. Both of them blend out really nicely. Okay, so this eye look currently looks very messy. Don't worry, I'll fix that. I realized that this look is a little darker than I wanted, so I'm gonna actually add in the other color that I wanted. So I'm gonna take the AOA E132 USA brush and the Makeup Shack in T9. So far, I feel like these pink brushes are actually doing pretty well. Oh yeah, that definitely made the look come together. This look is turning a lot darker than I intended, so I'm gonna add in Butter Cupcake with just the yellow into my crease. Now I'm gonna go in for the main lip color with the AOA E131 brush and the Makeup Geek Foiled Eyeshadow brush. And I'm gonna take Black Light from Makeup Geek and put that on the center of my lids. Okay, I have done my finessing as much as I could, so now I'm gonna go in with a makeup wipe and clean everything up. Now I'm gonna do the under eyes. So I'm taking the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Concealer in medium beige and medium tawny and just applying that. So today I'll be comparing the Beauty Blender versus the AOA sponge. The AOA sponge is really soft. I actually used both of these before and I really like the AOA sponge. For $1.55 and going to charity, this is really good. I actually bought a lot of backups of these already, so that's how you know it's good. But I'm gonna be demonstrating it for you. Can you imagine? I want to show you the little packaging that the Wonder Blender, the AOA one, comes in. It's a cute little bag. It has the seal. I don't even need to cut it. What I have in my hands is the little egg I used to clean the pink brushes. I don't know why I'm mentioning it in the middle of the video, but I am. I actually cleaned my brushes really well. I feel like that's the whole theme of this video. For $1 or $2, this stuff is really good. Like, honestly, someone could charge $5 for this. Or anything I mentioned, to me, honestly. Okay, I'm gonna set my eyes and do the rest of my face off camera because those are products that I didn't get anything from Shop Nisei, so I'll be right back. These highlighters are great. Now that a majority of my face is done, I'm gonna do my eyelashes with the AOA Studio Lash Curler and the other side with the Shu Uemura Mini Eyelash Curler, or is this, I think it's called the S Curler. And if I do mascara, I'm gonna brush it out with this little tool. Typically, I don't do mascara because my lashes just fall and lose their curl anyway. So I'm hoping that everything's gonna be okay with AOA. Oh, does anyone else just hold everything in their hands until they use it? I don't think all my little lashes are getting in there. Yeah, this is too big for my eye. I think I'm just gonna use a combination of both of these. I think I'm gonna skip out using this tool because I don't wanna do mascara since I have false lashes. Yes, I'm that girl who doesn't put mascara and blends into her false lashes. So I got a set of Alexis lashes from AOA Studio once again, and these look like bigger versions of Demi Wispies. So I'm just gonna cut them up and apply them to both of my eyes because that's ridiculous if I have two different eyelashes on. I like the way it opens, very easy. Let me cut them up and fit them to my eye and apply them with dual lash glue, but the latex free one because that one's much better. Friends, I got eyelash glue in my eye. Thank God it's latex free. I'm not a fan of these lashes. They're big, but they're sparse. They look like I have eyelash extensions and I need a fill. I'm gonna take these off and put on some iconic lights. I'm done with my makeup now. And I realized on camera, this lip color is very bright. If you want to know all my makeup details, they'll be in the description bar below. I want to say that these brushes are really good. I actually recommended these to a friend, and she bought them and she loves them. They're good for the everyday user. There's not a lot of detail brushes in here, but I don't think that's a big issue unless you're really doing intricate work. I think this is a really good set for $10.55. With the brush holder, the E122 brush was really good for carving out my brows. I also really like the AOA Wonder sponge. It's really fluffy and I enjoy it. I think I'll be switching to these from now on. I like this better than the RCMA, better than Pony Effect, better than that YesStyle one I tried in a couple videos ago. I think you should get any of these pink sponges, any of the charity set, because one, they're going to charity, and two, they perform better. I didn't use this E120 mascara brows brush, but I'm willing to try. I'll probably update the description once I try this out. This eyelash curler is okay. It's not my favorite, but I'm pretty sure it's not the worst. I also really liked how it came with the backup rubber applicator. What do you call that? But you guys can see on the screen in the close-up shots. So there you go. I also really like this egg brush cleaner. Cleaned all my brushes, kept my hands dry, and it's good. I also bought a brow razor set mainly because I wanted to shave my mustache. It came with another eyelash thing, so I want to see how that compares. I will let you know in the description. I also bought this cute little bear. He doesn't look like this in the photos, but it's so cute. I bought this charity pouch. It's so cute. It has little animals. It can hold quite a bit. And finally, I bought this little silk pouch so I can hold my earphones because the new iPhones don't come with earphone holders. What's up with that, Apple? I also really liked the Wonder Brow. I bought this E121 brush as well. I didn't have a use for it, so I'll find something. The lashes were not my favorite. These remind me of Daiso lashes. I feel like Daiso lashes are just as good. These tweezers, they do the job. I'm surprised. I'm not disappointed. All in all, I think Shop Nisei is a pretty good website. I'm actually gonna buy from them more often. Because of the sponge, the brushes. The brushes did not shed on me, and I've had Morphe brushes shed on me. I don't know if this helps you in your purchases, but I think this is a website you should check out if you find something you like. Plus, everything's really cheap. This is definitely better than the stuff you would find at a 99-cent store. And I also love how they do free shipping over $35 instead of $50, like most places. I appreciate that. Thank you, Shop Nisei. That concludes my review. I like Nisei. That's it for now. Don't forget to subscribe, follow me on Instagram and all my social medias. Once again, gotta make it out here. If you want to see my latest videos, they're gonna be right here. I'm pulling a Jackie Aina. Yes, I am. And I think that's it for now. I'll see you guys later. Bye.